I'm Tammy Kolda, an applied mathematician, and this is Unlocking LaTeX Graphics. On this YouTube channel, I am providing a detailed how-to guide on using ytick and PGFPLOTS. These videos are based on my book, Unlocking LaTeX Graphics, as well as some bonus materials. Today, I am going to explain 6 ways to set the axis ticks in PGFPLOTS. I can't wait to show you. This is the 3rd in a series of videos on PGFPLOTS and my 24th Unlocking LaTeX Graphics video overall. If you want to know more about ytick and PGFPLOTS, check out my other videos. I've already created a starting point for us with this document preamble. We're using the package PGFPLOTS, which is of course essential. Parskip and full page are just to make things look nice, and hyperref is so that I can link the author name back to the YouTube channel. The settings here are my recommended defaults for all documents that use PGFPLOTS. I'll link back to the episodes that explain these in the show notes. I'm also going to specify a few options for today's episode. I'm going to set the width and height to be 8x4 centimeters. I'm setting the font size for the tick labels, and finally, I'm setting the legend position to be in the lower left corner. The first way to set ticks is to let PGFPLOTS pick them for you. In my first picture, I'm plotting data from the file trig.txt, which I show below. By default, addplot selects the first column of the data table, which in this case is degrees, to be the x values. Now, the first addplot command here uses the sine column to be the y values. And the second addplot command uses the cosine column to be the y values. I've also added a legend and x label in the axis options. The ticks that PGFPLOTS picks by default are very reasonable. On the y-axis, it picks minus 1, 0, and 1. And on the x-axis, it goes from 0 to 350 in intervals of 50. This is pretty good with no hints from me. Before we go on, I want to show some tricks with styles because this will make the plots in the remainder of the video simpler and neater. First of all, I can move y equals sine from a table option to an add plot option as follows. I've just prepended the y with table slash. I can do the same thing with the cosine in the second add plot command. I move that again to the add plot options, just prepending it with the table slash. When I recompile this, nothing has changed in the plot. To make the code neater moving forward, I create 2 styles in PGFPLOT set that I can use over and over again. These styles are named sine and cosine, and they specify the look as well as the table column for the y values. When I recompile this with the change code, the plot is unchanged. This will make things simpler moving forward. The second way to set the ticks is something called tick distance. Here I've repeated the picture that we had before. What if I want the ticks to be every 60 degrees instead of every 50 degrees on the x-axis? The tick distance option allows me to give PGFPLOTS that hint. So if I set xtick distance equals 60, and then we recompile, then we see that the ticks go 0, 60, 120, up through 360. This is a super easy way to set your tick marks, and what I use most often when I want something other than the default ticks. The third way to set the ticks in PGFPLOTS is to use a data option. Here I'm going to paste xtick equals data and ytick equals data, and let's see the result. We see that the y-ticks have changed using the y-coordinates of the data. So now we have minus 1, minus 0.87, minus 0.5, all the way up to 1. Likewise for the x-ticks. Although these are evenly spaced, that is because the x-coordinates in the data are evenly spaced. The utility of this option depends on what you're trying to show, but I have occasionally found it useful. The fourth way to set the tick labels is to manually type them out. In this case, I could set the ticks to be 0, 60, all the way up through 360 by typing this command xtick equals 0, 60, dot, 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 360. Notice that I'm using dot, 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 and PGFPLOTS is able to figure out the pattern. When I'm using these kind of ticks, I could also go ahead and specify the labels. So let's go ahead and do that here. I say xtick labels equals 0, pi over 3, pi over 2, all the way up through 2 pi. One thing I want to point out is that xtick is singular, but xtick labels is plural. The fifth way to set the ticks is a special trick for logarithmic axes. I'm showing here a different plot on log-log axes to demonstrate this. Suppose I wanted the ticks to be 10 to the 1, 10 to the 3, 10 to the 5, up through 10 to the 9. How would I do that? Instead of using xtick to change the ticks, there's a command called xtick10 that requires only the exponents. Let me paste that here. Here I set xtick10 equal 1, 3, dot, 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 9. When I recompile this, now we see that it's picked out those x ticks on the logarithmic axis. The sixth way to set the ticks is to specify no ticks at all. Let's look at how you might do that. I'll start again with our sine and cosine plot. The natural way you might think to do this is to say, for example, x tick equals empty, y tick equals empty. So let's see what happens when we do that. When I compile it, it actually doesn't change at all. So we need a different way. You need a special incantation, which is slash empty. So let me show you what that looks like. Here we have ytick equals slash empty, xtick equals slash empty. When I compile that, the tick marks are gone as we wished. I hope you enjoyed today's video. You now know a sextet of ways to set your tick marks in PGFPLOTS. There's a link to the overleaf document we created today in the show notes. Please click like or subscribe if you want more videos like this. You can also buy my book, Unlocking LaTeX Graphics, at your favorite book retailer. Thanks for watching.